Welcome to my YouTube channel, Let's Learn. Dear students, you know, nowadays social media is becoming very popular and it is a means of communication. You are also acquainted with social media. We communicate with others in the social media like WhatsApp, your telephone, your TV, email, fax, etc. But you think, before some years, even nowadays, we were acquainted with communicating with others by writing letters. And nowadays, we are also writing letters, and the demand of post office is also in focus even nowadays. However, we write letters to our friends, to our neighbors, to our relatives. Have you ever written a letter to your friends or to your relatives? Perhaps yes. Have you ever written a letter to God? Perhaps not. A writer, a Mexican writer, has written a topic, a letter to God. It is a very interesting topic. The writer was also a novelist, a poet, and a journalist. And he was also awarded the National Prize of Arts and Science in the year 1935. Now, in this topic, he has reflected how a man is writing a letter to God. And who can write a letter to God? One who has faith on God. Only he can write, or only he can say something to God. Just like in this topic, a letter to God, he has focused a man who is the central character of this list, of this topic. He is a farmer. And now we will see the topic, a letter to God. See the topic. Okay? The topic begins from a house, a solitary house, which was located on the crest of a lawn. Crest means the top of a lawn. And it belonged to a farmer named Lencho. He was a very hard-working farmer. Hard-working means one who works very hard. And that was a solitary house on that entire valley. Solitary means only one house, a single house. And from that height, one could see the green field, the ripe corn field, the river, everything else. And on that valley, that year, there was a problem. What was the problem? The problem was there was no rain. The earth needed some water. A downpour or at least a shower of rain. A downpour means heavy rain because there was no rain, the land was dry, the corn was going to die. So it needed barely some water. Lencho, the farmer who was watching throughout the morning to the northeast sky, you must remember, northeast sky throughout the morning, and then what happened? Lencho lived with his family, his wife, his children. In the evening, when Lencho's wife was preparing supper for them, Lencho came and told his wife that we are going to get some water tonight. His wife immediately replied, yes, God willing. That means God willing means if God desires, then we will get some water. And at that time, his older children were working in the field, and his younger ones means younger children, were playing near his house. After some time, when Lencho's wife completed her supper, she called them to have their meal. Lencho and his children came for their meal, and they sat together. While they were taking their meal, just at that time, big drops of rain began to fall. And when big drops of rain began to fall, Lencho became happy because he thought his prediction was going to be true. That was prediction means his imagination, what he had thought earlier, that was going to be real. And then he went out, not for any other reason, only for a single reason, that is to have the pleasure of rain on his body. And when he came out, he saw big drops of rain were falling along with small ones. He compared the big drops of rain and the new coins, and the big drops are 5, big drops are 10 cent pieces and small ones are 5 cent pieces. Cent is the currency of Latin American countries. You know that the writer belongs to Mexico, a Latin American country. And in that country, the currency is called cent and peso. In India, you know very well that we have two types of currencies. The bigger one is called rupee and the smaller one is called paisa. Just like there in that country, the bigger one is called peso and the smaller one is called cent. Then what happened? Lencho became very excited. When it rained, he became very happy. But his happiness did not last like that. Within a very short period of time, or after some time, the rain changed. Suddenly, a strong wind blew and the rain turned into hailstones. Very large hailstones began to fall. And when very large hailstones began to fall, Lencho compared it with new silver coins. Now, you must mark this thing. New silver coins, he compared with the the hailstones, or the hailstones are compared with new silver coins, and it is compared by Lencho. And then his children, they went out to collect the frozen pearls. Here, frozen pearls are the hailstones. Then what happened? Lencho thought the hailstone will pass very quickly, but it continued for an hour. When it continued for an hour, the entire valley, means the cornfield, the house, the cornfield, everywhere the hailstones cover, and it resembled as if it covered with salt. Now here there is a comparison the writer has given us. It resembled as if it covered with salt, not snow. This is very important. Then after an hour, when storm stopped, Lencho with his children went to his cornfield to see what had happened. And what he saw, that was out of his imagination. That means he could not have imagined that such a thing would have happened. Not a single leaf remained on the trees. That means the trees were leafless. His cornfield was completely destroyed. And when his cornfield was completely destroyed, he told his sons that if locusts would have destroyed, they would have left more than this. Locust, see the picture. Locust is an insect which destroys corn. Then he became extremely unhappy and told his family that they will go hungry this year. But his family members, those who were living in that solitary house in that valley, they suggested Lencho that no one dies of hunger during disaster. God helps. So there is only one hope, that God will help us. And nobody in this valley will help us except God. And then you know that it was night. That night was a sorrowful one. Lencho could not sleep. He could only think, or he was only thinking, there is only one hope from God, that God will help. And he thought, God can see even in the deep of one's conscience. Conscience means the inner sense of right or wrong of any human being. In Odia, it may say, be back. So, I will tell you, ଆମର ଓଡ଼ିଆରେ ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ରାର୍ଥନା ଅଛି, ଯାହା ମୁଁ କହି ଯାହା ମୁଁ କରଇ ଯାହା ମୁଁ ଚିନ୍ତଇ ମନେ ଜଗତର କର୍ତ୍ତା ପରମ ଈଶ୍ୱର ଜାଣୁଛନ୍ତି ପ୍ରତିକ୍ଷଣ। ତେଣୁ ଏ ଗୋଟିଏ କଥାରେ ପିଲାମାନେ ଟିକେ ମନେ ରଖ, ଯେ ଆମେ ଯାହା କହୁଛନ୍ତି, ଯାହା କରୁଛନ୍ତି, ଯାହା ଚିନ୍ତା କରୁଛନ୍ତି, ଯାହା ଭାବୁଛନ୍ତି, ଏ ଜଗତର କର୍ତ୍ତା ସ୍ୱୟଂ ଭଗବାନ ଇଏ ପ୍ରତିକ୍ଷଣରେ ପ୍ରତି ମୁହୂର୍ତ୍ତରେ ସବୁକିଛି ଜାଣିପାରନ୍ତି। ଆଜି ଲେଞ୍ଚର ମନ ସେଇଆ ହେଇଛି। Lencho thought, God will definitely know my problem and will help during my bad days. And then One idea came to his mind. He thought to write a letter to God. The following Sunday, at the day break, he started to write a letter to God. It was nothing else except a letter to God. And in the next part, means in part two, I will discuss what he had written in the letter and what happened. Then, now you see the difficult words and note it down for your reference. Thank you. If you like my video, then like, comment and share. And don't forget to subscribe my channel and click on the bell icon to get the new notifications of my new videos. Thank you.